Dobry večer, good evening, and welcome to this, the second installment in the Ukrainian Shumka Dancers' Pathways to Kobzar series. I'm delighted you could be a part of it, that you could help us to enrich this evening with your presence. My name is Roman Brytan from 1017 World FM and other undisclosed locations. And it's just a delight that I have a personal history with the Ukrainian Shumka Dancers, largely through my work in the media, but also through connections with many, many members of the company for many years, in fact, decades. And the one thing I can say is when Shumka gives you a call, you answer, because it's a group that stands out above all the others in many different ways. Not that they necessarily say that they are the best, but that they strive to do things differently. They strive to find new avenues of expression. They strive to take the cultural base on which we all begin our work and take it into all kinds of new directions. And Kobzar, which of course premieres on the Northern Alberta Jubilee Auditorium stage on April 9th and 10th, is a very, very wonderful example of just that. I think and you may or may not be of Ukrainian descent, but one thing that I can tell you about being a part of the community or a supporter of the community is I think there may be some reference to the four pillars of Taras Shevchenko, the national poet of Ukraine, and the inspiration behind this work a little bit later on by people who are better versed in what created this work. But there are four other pillars I'd just like to identify as we start out the evening, and that is four pillars of Ukrainian consciousness, for lack of a better term. One is a consciousness of national history and nationality. And it's something that's really woven into the DNA of people who identify with Ukrainian culture and with Ukrainian history. Whether you're a member of the diaspora, as many of us are, or whether you're born and raised and still living in Ukraine today, it's something that's really it can't be defined, but it's definitely felt and I think sensed by everybody. The second is the pillar of belonging. It's like a sense of family from selo or village to city, wherever you exist, on many different levels, each individually and yet collectively, people also understand exactly what's being expressed. The third is faith and spirituality, inspired by his incredibly encyclopedic knowledge of both the Old Testament and the application of faith to what informed really the development of Ukrainian history on many different levels. And the fourth is cultural expression. At the end of the day, it's not about what you keep inside of you, it's what comes out of all of this together. And cultural expression is what the Ukrainian Shumka Dancers, of course, are all about. It's about sharing that, not only with fellow Ukrainians, but with the rest of the world. And they've done so on many different levels and in many very innovative and interesting ways in the past. And again, here we go. Here's another work that we know is going to resonate and is going to become a very strong part of not only their repertoire, but just the Ukrainian cultural milieu. So it's very exciting to see this happening. And these evenings in particular are exciting because they let us build up to that culmination, which is the show itself, and get a bit more of a context and understanding of what brings us to where we are. We're going to have a very short program this evening. We just want to give you, as I said, a context, to have you meet some of the players that are involved, to understand what's behind some of this. And in particular tonight, we are celebrating, of course, the works of artist Valery Semenko and how they have been incorporated in an absolutely new and innovative way for Shumka's history into this production. And that means from a technical standpoint and also from the way in which they were part of the creative process. So without further ado, I'd just like to, first of all, introduce someone who can give you more of a background about this so that you can understand this art as inspiration for Kobzar.